the age of modern engineering marvels, we pride ourselves on sophisticated technology and precision. Yet, astonishingly, there exist medieval structures so ingeniously crafted that even contemporary engineers struggle to fully explain their construction methods. One such enigmatic structure has baffled experts for centuries, leaving us to question how, without the advanced tools we possess today, medieval craftsmen managed to achieve seemingly impossible feats. In this video, we'll explore the astonishing details of this remarkable medieval building, delving deep into its design, construction, and the enduring mysteries surrounding it. What secrets did medieval builders hold that still elude our understanding today? At the heart of our investigation lies one of the medieval world's most astonishing architectural achievements, the incredible dome of Florence Cathedral, also known as the Duomo di Firenze. Built during the early Renaissance but designed using entirely medieval techniques, its sheer scale and complexity have confounded generations of architects and engineers. Constructed between 1420 and 1436, under the guidance of master builder Filippo Brunelleschi, the dome remains the largest brick dome ever built. Rising over 114 meters, 374 feet, into the sky, it stands as a symbol of human ingenuity and ambition. Yet remarkably, Brunelleschi left behind no detailed plans or blueprints. Modern engineers, armed with computers, complex mathematics, and advanced machinery, still grapple to fully explain how Brunelleschi and his builders achieved this extraordinary feat. The dome's enormous size presented unprecedented challenges. Traditional wooden scaffolding used in medieval construction was impractical at this height, forcing Brunelleschi to innovate entirely new techniques. The builders devised groundbreaking methods, including a herringbone brick pattern and an intricate internal support system that balanced tension and compression perfectly. Brunelleschi's approach to constructing the dome was radically innovative for his time. One of his most significant achievements was designing a self-supporting structure, eliminating the need for temporary wooden supports. To accomplish this, he employed a unique double-shell design, essentially constructing two domes, one nestled within the other, that reinforced each other structurally. This double-shell system allowed for pathways and staircases between the two layers, facilitating both construction and maintenance. The outer shell protected the structure from weather and external pressures, while the inner shell provided crucial support. The gap between these layers reduced the overall weight, distributing forces efficiently and evenly, a concept astonishingly ahead of its time. Equally remarkable was the precise bricklaying technique Brunelleschi used, known as the herringbone pattern. Bricks were arranged diagonally rather than horizontally, interlocking tightly and redistributing structural stress. This method prevented the massive dome from collapsing under its own weight during construction and allowed workers to build steadily upward without fearing structural failure. Today, engineers use advanced computer models and calculations to understand how these medieval builders could achieve such precise balance and stability. Yet, despite modern advancements, the dome's sheer perfection remains partially inexplicable, a testament to the intuitive genius of medieval craftsmen. Without modern cranes or sophisticated lifting equipment, Brunelleschi faced the challenge of raising thousands of tons of materials over 100 meters into the air. His solution was to invent entirely new machinery, some of which remain enigmatic even today. Among these devices was an ox-driven hoist that featured a groundbreaking reversible gear system, allowing loads to be raised and lowered without repositioning animals, a significant advancement for the time. Additionally, Brunelleschi designed an ingenious crane, known as the Castello, capable of precisely positioning heavy stones and bricks high above the ground. This crane employed pulleys, gears, and counterweights, which greatly improved efficiency and safety during construction. Remarkably, these machines not only solved practical construction problems, but also laid foundations for engineering principles still used today. Modern engineers attempting to recreate Brunelleschi's inventions from historical records have encountered difficulties. Detailed descriptions are scarce, and sketches left behind are incomplete or missing critical components. These gaps force modern experts to speculate and test theories, highlighting just how advanced and intuitive medieval engineering was, despite the absence of scientific frameworks available today. A significant part of the mystery surrounding Brunelleschi's dome is the knowledge lost over the centuries. Medieval builders typically transmitted their expertise orally or through apprenticeships, rarely leaving comprehensive written instructions. Brunelleschi himself was notoriously secretive, careful not to disclose all his methods, partly due to fear of competition and partly due to guild practices of the time. This secrecy meant that some techniques used in constructing the dome were never properly documented and gradually faded into obscurity after Brunelleschi's death. The master builder also carefully controlled access to the building site, ensuring few outsiders could observe the most critical phases of construction. Thus, crucial details were effectively lost to history. Today's researchers comb through limited historical records, examining traces of construction process embedded within the dome itself. Advanced imaging technology, such as 3D scanning and ground-penetrating radar, has revealed previously unknown structural details. Yet, despite these technological insights, many questions remain unanswered, reminding us of the remarkable depth of medieval practical knowledge. One of the most baffling aspects of Brunelleschi's dome lies in its geometric precision, achieved long before the invention of modern measuring tools or computer-assisted design. Medieval builders relied heavily on geometry, using basic tools such as compasses, ropes, and squares. Yet the accuracy they attained is astonishingly comparable to today's standards. Brunelleschi had to calculate precise angles, curvatures, and load distributions, all without written formulas or digital aids. Remarkably, he employed intuitive mathematical principles derived from ancient texts and practical experience. By using a meticulous combination of ropes and wooden templates, builders could replicate exact shapes and measurements consistently at great heights. Even more fascinating was their ability to create structural harmony through proportion. Brunelleschi's design was influenced by classical Roman architecture, notably the Pantheon. Yet he expanded on these ancient concepts with groundbreaking ingenuity. The dome's octagonal base gradually transitions to a circular apex, an architectural feat requiring flawless mathematical transitions that still amaze engineers today. Modern attempts to reverse engineer Brunelleschi's methods through sophisticated software sometimes reveal discrepancies that experts can't fully resolve. This highlights how intuitive and adaptive medieval builders were, achieving extraordinary precision through trial, error, and unparalleled skill. One of the greatest mysteries surrounding Brunelleschi's dome is its remarkable resilience. The dome has survived nearly six centuries, enduring numerous earthquakes, severe storms, and human conflict without significant structural compromise. How did medieval craftsmen construct a dome that not only defied gravity, but resisted centuries of natural disasters? Brunelleschi's innovative double-shell design was a significant factor contributing to this durability. By creating two separate but interconnected domes, he effectively dispersed structural stresses and allowed for subtle movements without compromising integrity. The inner dome acted as a load-bearing structure, evenly distributing weight, while the outer dome provided protective reinforcement, preventing moisture and temperature variations from damaging the core. Further enhancing the dome's resilience was the use of flexible materials, particularly the lime-based mortar. Unlike modern cement, this mortar remained elastic, accommodating slight shifts caused by ground movement or weather fluctuations without cracking or crumbling. The ingenious herringbone brick pattern also ensured that pressure was uniformly dispersed, significantly reducing vulnerability to seismic activity. Modern structural analysis confirms that Brunelleschi's dome is remarkably well-suited to its environment. However, the intuitive understanding medieval engineers had of seismic dynamics still exceeds clear explanation. Their techniques were empirical, developed through observation and experience rather than theoretical calculations. Despite today's sophisticated engineering models and extensive seismic research, replicating Brunelleschi's achievements remains elusive. Brunelleschi's dome was not merely an engineering marvel. It was a profound symbolic statement of human aspiration, religious devotion, and civic pride. Medieval society perceived monumental structures as tangible representations of spiritual connection and community strength. The dome of Florence Cathedral embodied these ideals, standing as an enduring symbol of Florence's cultural renaissance and spiritual rebirth. From its inception, the dome was envisioned as a heavenly vault, mirroring the divine order believed to govern the universe. Its towering height and graceful curvature drew the eye upward, inspiring awe and spiritual contemplation among observers. This wasn't just architectural ambition. It was a deliberate attempt to bridge earthly existence with the divine. Brunelleschi masterfully infused symbolism into every structural detail, aligning architecture with theology in ways that modern observers still find deeply impressive. The project also reflected Florence's rising political status and self-confidence during the Renaissance. The city aimed to surpass rival cities by constructing an unprecedented structure, symbolizing its wealth, power, and intellectual sophistication. Brunelleschi, therefore, wasn't just an architect. He was the orchestrator of a powerful civic statement, intended to elevate Florence's prestige across Europe. Modern engineers and historians continue to explore how these symbolic dimensions influence the dome's design and construction. While today's engineering largely prioritizes practicality, Brunelleschi's work reveals an age when technical achievement was inseparable from spiritual and civic purpose. Brunelleschi's dome not only astounded his contemporaries, but also profoundly influenced generations of architects and engineers who followed. The sheer ingenuity and creativity he demonstrated became foundational to the Renaissance, inspiring a wave of architectural innovation throughout Europe. Brunelleschi essentially revived and advanced lost Roman construction techniques, setting a new benchmark that continues to inspire awe and study today. In the decades following its completion, the dome attracted architects from across Europe who traveled vast distances to study its construction methods firsthand. It became a living classroom, offering lessons in structural engineering, aesthetics, and practical problem solving. As these architects returned home, they carried Brunelleschi's groundbreaking ideas with them, influencing countless buildings throughout the continent and beyond. Yet, the dome's influence extended far beyond Europe. Centuries later, architects and engineers worldwide continued to reference Brunelleschi's innovations when tackling challenging construction problems. Notably, the principles he pioneered, such as the double-shell dome, strategic use of tension and compression, and self-supporting construction, have informed contemporary landmark structures, including modern sports stadiums and monumental public buildings. Even today, engineering students and professionals study the dome as a masterclass in structural harmony and intuitive problem solving. Its legacy serves as a constant reminder that the foundations of modern architecture often rest upon the ingenuity of the medieval past. Brunelleschi's dome demonstrates that true innovation is timeless and that groundbreaking solutions can transcend the limitations of their era. While Brunelleschi's dome remains remarkably resilient, modern engineers face ongoing challenges in preserving and maintaining this medieval wonder. Pollution, vibrations from urban traffic, and the impact of millions of annual visitors create continuous stress on the centuries-old structure. Preserving the dome's integrity without compromising its authenticity presents a significant contemporary challenge. Today's preservationists carefully balance technological intervention with respect for historical accuracy. Cutting-edge techniques such as laser scanning, 3D modeling, and microscopic analysis are regularly employed to monitor structural health. These technologies allow specialists to detect minute fractures or signs of wear long before they become critical issues, facilitating timely repairs that remain faithful to original materials and methods. However, despite such advanced tools, there are areas within the dome's construction still inaccessible or incompletely understood. Certain internal passages and structural elements remain obscured, either deliberately sealed by Brunelleschi's team or naturally blocked over time. This limitation complicates restoration efforts, leaving some repairs speculative and cautiously experimental, underscoring once again the dome's lingering mysteries. Preservation experts also grapple with ethical dilemmas. How much intervention is appropriate to protect historical authenticity? Brunelleschi's dome serves as a global heritage icon, making decisions about restoration or reinforcement highly complex. Modern engineers must therefore operate not merely as technicians, but as caretakers of a profoundly symbolic cultural legacy, navigating challenges Brunelleschi himself could scarcely have imagined. Brunelleschi's dome is more than an extraordinary feat of engineering. It symbolizes the boundless creativity, ambition, and ingenuity inherent in human endeavor. Its enduring mysteries serve as humbling reminders that advanced technology alone cannot fully explain or replicate the intuitive genius of historical builders. Even as we progress technologically, there remains deep respect for the achievements of our medieval predecessors, whose work continues to inspire awe centuries later. Understanding the dome's secrets challenges us to reconsider what we believe about medieval craftsmanship, intelligence, and ambition. The dome stands as a testament to human innovation and determination, achieved without the sophisticated aids of modern engineering. Perhaps its greatest lesson is that the power of human ingenuity transcends time and technology, reminding us that remarkable achievements are born not only from technical skill, but also from creative vision, relentless experimentation, and sheer persistence. Brunelleschi's dome continues to captivate, educate, and inspire millions. As engineers and historians unravel its complexities, the dome reinforces an important truth. The past is not merely a relic, but a source of continual inspiration, urging us to reach higher, dream bigger, and build for eternity. What aspect of Brunelleschi's incredible dome fascinated you most? Share your thoughts in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more intriguing explorations into engineering history.